Hey guys, what's going on? It's your friendly neighborhood Latin Nerd Cosfield here, and I got something great to show you guys. You guys know that I've been cosplaying for quite a couple of years, and I have gotten my latest suit from none other than my favorite cosplay makers, of course, the making of Spider-Man of RPC Studios. He's in the background. I wore my Kai Arts for the past last year, and this year, not only I just got this suit, but also buying other suits in the next couple. I just bought this suit, but I'm getting it for the next couple of months, so hopefully I get it by before the year end, because I would show you that suit in really soon. The difference is that this suit, I already wore this suit already, and I already did some shoots and everything, so I'm gonna put some together of a little stuff that I did in a photo shoot. And this suit I got is really the suit that I've been looking for of wearing ever since I saw the suit in based on the video game. If you play this game, is Spider-Man Shattered Dimensions, with pretty much all the 5 Spider-Men in one game. The Amazing Spider-Man, the Symbiote Spider-Man. Is it 5 or 4? Well, it's 4. 4 or 5. 4 or 5. 1 or 2. I can't remember. And it's one of my favorite games. And that's the first time playing, seeing Deadpool in that game too. But yeah, so this is Shadow Dimension. It's with Amazing Spider-Man, Symbiote Spider-Man. And first time ever seeing Noah Spider-Man, which he might do him in the future wise. And last but not least, Spider-Man 2099. I was so mesmerized about him, and I played another Spider-Man game called Spider-Man Edge of Time. Saw his suit and I fell in love with his suit. Not the one with the white and the blue, the one with the blue and the shirt represent the day of the dead. The reason why I got that suit, because I would tell you guys know that the Spider-Man 2099 is not Peter Parker. He is a character name, well, a character behind the mask. His name is Miguel O'Hara, who is a half Mexican, half Irish, and he is from the year 2099. And of course, all the Marvel superheroes are pretty different in that year. So I want to be him, because why not to be a Hispanic Latin learned cosplayer, to be more Latin learned cosplayer based characters. So I'm gonna put on the suit and I'm gonna give you my full review of the suit. Oh, by the way, I just ordered a facial too from another guy. His name, I cannot pronounce his name, but I'm gonna put his name right on the side. His name is Erwan Wanda, whatever. But he made my facial, and I'm gonna give you both reviews of RBC and his facial review. Keep in mind, guys, I wore this suit before, and I'm not saying it's worn out. I'm just saying there is some stuff that you probably gonna see differently compared to what you see before. But I'm gonna post some good things before. I'm gonna show you guys the video, and then also show you guys the whole suit. So let me get dressed and let's just see what happens. Here we go, guys, my suit. As you see, the size. They made it out of they put foam inside this thing. It's like a little fin type of thing. Anyways, kind of cool. I know everybody else usually got the other one, the other version, which is, I know it's shorter. But I really like this one more, because you could fit it, and it could be straight, or it could be bendable. And also, this suit is, the pattern is made by Brandon Gilbert. I recommend you to get his suit, because his suit is so awesome, so dope. He makes all kinds of variation from Marvel and DC, and even some he also does a lot of Overwatch patterns as well. So, but yeah, so here's this my little toy of my suit. Very shaded, very, you can see my little area. It's by the booty, of course. This is his pattern, and I chose it because, you know, he has a perfect pattern. Don't really have to shade it that much. You don't really have to puff it, and you guys see it. You can see, you know, how, you know, detailed or scaly it looks. You know, because that's what I like about Spider-Man 2099, because his skin is so, like, tight skin. But even though it's not tight skin, because he does make his school out of spandex. And again, it looks like a Punisher symbol, but it's actually the Day of the Dead type of symbol, which is kind of recommend also of how the Punisher, you know, does his chest thing as well, because it does represent Day of the Dead. So the next thing I'm gonna put on is the mask. So be prepared, guys. This mask is way different compared to the other mask of my amazing Hooded Spider-Man, because the both masks are different. So I'm going to do, you know, give you my impression, or give you guys, you know, a show tell of how the mask should look. So now you get ready, because this mask is going to be one heck to put on. Well, here it is, guys, the mask. So I'm going to try to yell as loud as I can, because it is a face show. So if you guys can hear me, just leave a comment, because my mouth should be moving. Hopefully I get a mic for this camera soon. But yeah, this is the mask, and the facial is the side, and the lens is not playing on form. It's actually kind of like metalish, metal type of lens, which is like kind of a unique take of his lens. And but yeah, this is the Irvine facial, and the mask is, of course, is the RPC Studios mask, which is, has the holes in the eyes. Like I said, I already did some little outside shoot, so I'm gonna show you some demonstration of how I did in the shoot. So before I do that, I'm just letting you know that this is, I wore this suit before. So I hope you guys enjoyed the video, and I'm gonna give you my full review about this suit as soon as this video goes back. So yeah, guys, that's my little run through of the suit. I was, you know, at South CC Port doing my thing. Did it for the suit. You can put, you can see it on the side. I'm putting on the pictures on the side so you guys can see it. And it came out. Oh, I'm trying to put it for you. It came out great. The pictures came out great. Okay, here are the con about this suit. Okay, when I ordered this suit for the first time, I mean, not order it the first time, but be prepared. If you guys order your suit, make sure you double check everything, including your measurements, including your measurements of your comfort shoes. I bought this suit, and I accidentally bought a wrong shoe size, so I had to buy another comfort shoe. So the lining is not that great, because the shoe thing that I accidentally ordered myself was like a small size, which I am more like a, you know, like 8.5 size shoes in comfort shoes, which is about like 42 43 euro size. So yeah, they go by euro if you guys getting comfort shoes, and make sure you get the right actual size for your feet, not your sneaker size, because it'll be too big, unless you want to make it more stretchable, but I doubt it might work. So that's one thing. So yeah, I just switch shoes, that's one. And two, this mask, this face shell is good, but not great. It's really tight on my face. And another thing is that this face shell is made out of resin. The resin, if you guys remember, I wear my Psychovest helmet, which I did a review on that. That's made out of resin, which is sort of hard to breathe more compared to my Amazing Spider-Man, because that was made out of plastic. This is made out of resin. So, and then the lens is also made out of like resin mixed with metal type of thing. It was fiberglass. It's made out of fiberglass, and
It's kind of unique, but it's not perfect. I would recommend you get a face shell with a lens that's made out of like plastic or rubber, like similar to like my Kai-Os lens, because those lenses are way perfect, way comfortable. Get for free or get it a glossy type. Just make sure you don't put some holes to get some air or anti-fog spray. If that be help. And also, just research. I know there's a lot of great facial out there. For me personally, I would go prefer with low lens, just faces lens attached. But since I want to try his facial for the first time, it's good. And also, if you guys look so closely, let's just see if we see. There's some cracks already. Dropped a couple of times on the floor, and the size of the with the lens around is breaking. So just give you a heads up, you guys will order his facial. His facial is made out of resin and fiberglass. So be careful. It's like same thing with your palm region lens mask and helmets. Make sure you be careful with that too, cause those things break. Like anything that's made with resin or fiberglass, just be careful. Don't let it drop so many times. You could try to repair it, but at the same time, you gotta make sure you gotta get the right paint and another resin, and you gotta do, sanding and all the stuff like that.
Ooh, I am hot. Yeah, this is made out of, but as you see, like, if I'm gonna put the light a little more closer so you guys can see. As you see, it's made out of resin. You can see it's not plastic. And as I'll tell you about the cracks as well, I'm gonna try to be really careful. There are some cracks on the side, which is right here. I had to put on. If you guys see it, so you can see the crack right there. So just to let you know, if you buy his face shell, just be very careful. Like I said, it's made out of fiberglass and resin, and it's similar to like the Power Ranger helmet, like my Circle Red helmet, which is made out of fiberglass and resin. And it's a good helmet, it's a good mask, but they are not very great to wear it all day because it has some fumes inside. So in case you guys, any Spider-Man cosplayers who are asthmatic like myself, just be careful, wearing facial. Facial is not a number one priority to wear these things. So if my recommendation, I will recommend lens attach and also fog-free lens. So that way, you could breathe, and you could either get a fog-free and get a glossy sealed lens. Just make sure you get the anti-spray fog spray, so that way it's much easier. But yeah, so that's pretty much it, guys. I'm gonna do so much stuff with this suit. I'm actually gonna buy another facial. I'm definitely gonna probably buy the one for RPC Studio, and also thinking getting the one face lens attached with this suit, because like I said, I prefer lens attached. But the lenses could be much more different compared to this one, so just letting you guys know. So if you guys see other pictures and other videos, if my lens looks different from the 2099, because I got it from either RPC Studio or another person who makes lenses and facial attached. But yeah, what do you guys think about this suit? If you guys had the same exact suit, just let me know. You guys get the same exact suit at Sanitize Zone. I'm gonna put the link below where you can get Brandon Gilbert's pattern. And also, I'm gonna put my Sanitize Zone link with my special discount code, so you guys can buy it for yourself, or you can buy any other patterns the website from Brandon Gilbert or any other designers there too as well. And also, I had so much stuff going on. I'm focusing on my photography. Like I said in my last video, I'm focusing on my photography. And I have a huge cosplay group that's coming out in the next couple of weeks. And also, I will be in Big Apple Conference. That's going to be in April, so guys, check that out. And I will post more videos as much as I can. Whether I'm busy, more cosplay videos, more fun stuff video, and more skits. Who knows? You never know. Maybe a skit could happen next week, because I have a couple of my friends coming over. So, but anyway, guys, like, subscribe, comment, and I will see you guys Later. Bye.